Hello everyone, welcome to Pharmachemistry classroom. Our today's topic is aromaticity. And today we are going to discuss what is aromaticity, what are the criteria for aromaticity, Hucker's rule, and a simple trick to remember, hybridization. Whether a molecule is aromatic or not, based on that, there are three types of molecules. First one is aromatic. Second is anti-aromatic, third is non-aromatic. We'll see first what is aromaticity. Aromaticity is a property of cyclic planar molecules with a ring of resonance bond that gives increased stability due to the ability of electrons in pi orbitals to delocalize. So I'll make you understand, the aromaticity is a particular property of cyclic planar molecule with a ring of resonance bonds, okay, that gives increased stability to this ring molecule due to the ability of their electrons in pi orbitals to delocalize. Now there are some criteria for aromaticity. First is the molecule should be cyclic or it has a ring structure. Second is the molecule is planar, that's all the atoms in the molecule lie in the same plane. Third one, molecule is fully conjugated, that is it has a sp2 hybridization. Fourth one, the molecule has 4n plus 2 pi electrons where n is equal to 0 or any other positive integer. Now we are going to see all these criteria one by one. First criteria, that is the molecule is cyclic in nature. What is the meaning of cyclic compound? A cyclic compound is a compound in which one or more series of atoms in the compound is connected to form a ring. There are three types of cyclic compounds. First one is carbocycle, second is heterocyclic compounds, and third is inorganic cyclic compounds. Carbocycles, as the name indicates, it is made up of, the ring is made up of carbon atoms only. In heterocyclics, the ring is made up of carbon atoms and non-carbon atoms also. Inorganic cyclic compounds are made up of inorganic atoms. See here examples. One first one is benzene. Benzene is an example for carbocycle. You can see the ring is made up of only carbon, and this furan is an example for heterocyclic compounds because it's made up of carbon and a non-carbon atom also. Second criteria is the molecule is planar in nature. That is, all of its atoms lie in the same plane. Example given is benzene. Next, an important criteria is the molecule is fully conjugated. Conventionally, we define conjugated molecules as molecules having alternating single and multiple bond. Remember, we have conventionally defined conjugated molecules as molecules having alternating single and double bonds. So, here we are going to redefine conjugated molecule as molecules having side-to-side overlap of p orbitals at every atom in the ring. So, how we are going to redefine conjugation here? To make aromaticity clearer, we are going to redefine conjugated or fully conjugated as a molecule having side-to-side overlap of p orbital at every atom in the ring. So, you can see here, given an example given, this is one carbon atom and this is another carbon atom having a p orbital, and there is a lateral overlapping between these p orbital to get pi bond. So, meaning of a fully conjugated molecule is each atom present in the ring must have a side-to-side overlap of p orbital. So, to have a side-to-side overlap, what should be there? There should be a p orbital at every atom in the ring. Okay. I have mentioned already, to be fully conjugated, there should be one p orbital in each atom of the ring. So, in a cyclic conjugated ring, each atom in the ring will be in a sp2 hybridization. Then it has a 1p orbital. Okay. So, there should be 1p orbital in each atom, which is possible when each atom in the ring is in sp2 hybridization. So, I'll explain you how. This is carbon atom. having its configuration 1s2, 2s2 and 2p2. Now it undergo hybridization, that is shift of one of the electrons from 2s orbital to pz orbital to get hybridization. So in this, if suppose the hybridization is sp3, then what happened? This 1s orbital and 3p orbital intermix together to get 4sp3 hybridized orbitals. So see here, when 1s orbital and 3p orbital mix together, you will get 4sp3 hybridized orbital. There is no p orbital in this sp3 hybridization. Next, we are going to see what if there is sp2 hybridization take place. So this is we have seen already sp3 hybridization. Now we'll see what if there is sp2 hybridization. 1s orbital and 2p orbital mix together to get sp2 hybridized orbital, 3sp2 hybridized orbital, and we have 1p orbital in the atom which can undergo lateral overlapping. Clear? If sp2 hybridization is present in the atom of the ring, there should be or there will be 1p orbital, so that our one of the criteria is satisfied. Here is a simple tip to remember the type of hybridization present in an atom. The number of hybridized orbitals is equal to number of attached atoms plus number of lone pairs of electrons. So we know already that the type of hybridization and the number of hybridized orbitals are related to each other. So if the number of hybridized orbitals are 4, so the hybridization type is sp3. If the number of hybridized orbitals are 3, the hybridization is sp2. If 2 hybridized orbitals are present, type of hybridization is sp hybridization. So based on the number of hybridized orbitals, we can predict what kind of hybridization present in the atom. See an example where hydrogen and carbon and their electronic configuration is mentioned. And here there is an example that is methane molecule which has carbon and 4 hydrogens attached to it. So after sp3 hybridization, that is 1s orbital and 3p orbitals intermix to get 4sp3 hybridized orbitals, where 4 hydrogen atoms come and attach, we get sp3 hybridization. By looking at this carbon which has 4 attached atoms and there is no lone pairs of electrons, we get 4 hybridized orbitals in it, and quickly we can guess the hybridization is sp3. Another example is benzene. We know that in benzene, each carbon is attached to other 3 atoms. See here, this carbon is attached to a neighboring 2 carbon atoms and 1 hydrogen atom. So number of hybridized orbitals is equal to number of atoms attached, which is 3, plus lone pairs of electrons. There is no lone pairs of electron present in this carbon. So number of hybridized orbitals is equal to 3. When 3 hybridized orbitals are present, our hybridization type is sp2. There is an exception for this rule. This is the exception for the rule that if an atom has one or more lone pairs and this atom is attached to a sp2 hybridized atom, then the atom is also sp2 hybridized. I'll make you understand. Look at this example. In this example, we can see this oxygen atom, and we need to find out what kind of hybridization is there for this oxygen atom, which has lone pairs of electron. So now, see this neighboring atom, neighboring carbon atom, which is bonded to other 3 atoms, one oxygen, other carbon and one hydrogen. So when it is attached to 3 atoms and there is no lone pairs of electron in this carbon, the hybridization of this carbon is sp2. So look at the oxygen here, which has lone pair of electron and which is attached to another atom, which is a sp2 hybridization. So based on this exception rule, we can say the hybridization of this oxygen is also sp2 hybridization. Next is our fourth and important criteria, that is the molecule should have 4n plus 2 pi electrons where n is equal to 0 or any other positive integer. This rule is proposed by German chemist and physicist Erich Huckel in 1931, and the rule states that if a planar cyclic molecule has 4n plus 2 pi electrons, it is considered as aromatic, and this rule is known as Huckel's rule. The rule states, if a cyclic planar molecule has 4n plus 2 pi electrons in it, it is considered as aromatic. Huckel's rule is a set of algorithms that combine the number of pi electrons, that is capital N, and the physical structure of the ring system to determine whether a molecule is aromatic, anti-aromatic or non-aromatic. So we'll see, what is a pi electron, or how can you tell which electrons are pi electrons? Pi electrons are those electron which resides in the pi bond, that is the electrons resides in the pi bond of a double bond or triple bond or in a conjugated p orbital. So these kind of electrons are known as pi electrons. Now with the algorithm in detail, the number of pi electrons in an aromatic system can be determined by the equation capital N is equal to 4N plus 2. Capital N is the number of pi electrons. N, small n, is an integer which may be 0 or any other positive integer. Next is the number of pi electrons in an anti-aromatic system can be determined by number of pi electrons capital N is equal to 4N, where small n is an integer. And if a compound does not have a continuous ring of conjugated p orbitals in the planar conformation, then it is a non-aromatic compound. Now we are going to check whether benzene is aromatic or not, or whether benzene molecules satisfy all the four criteria to be aromatic. Now we'll see benzene and its aromaticity. This is the structure of benzene. It's a cyclic hydrocarbon compound with alternating single and double bonds. Each carbon is attached to one hydrogen and two other carbon atoms. So therefore, each carbon is sp2 hybridized. How we can understand that? This carbon is attached to two other carbon atom and one hydrogen atom here. So this is the other hydrogen atom. So this carbon is bonded to three other atoms and there is no lone pair present in it. So the hybridization or the number of hybridized orbital is equal to 3. Therefore, the carbon has sp2 hybridization. You see here the carbon 1s2, 2s2 and 2p2, and it get hybridized, that is one of the electrons from 2s orbital shifted or promoted to 2pz orbital to get hybridized orbitals, and the hybridization is sp2 hybridization, we have seen already. Now see here, sp2 hybridization, 1s orbitals and 2p orbitals mixed together to get 3 sp2 hybridized orbitals, so that one carbon, two carbons and one hydrogen can attach to it or can bond with it, and there is one unpaired electron in the pz orbital which can contribute to the pi system. So each carbon atom in sp2 hybridized benzene has one p orbital and one unpaired electron in it. So you can see here this dumbbell, yellow dumbbells given, are our p orbital having one unpaired electron in it. So each carbon has one unpaired electron, so total 6 carbons, so total 6 unpaired electrons, and they can laterally overlap like this. This lateral overlapping gives us 3 double bonds, okay. So each double bond always contributes 2 pi electrons. Here benzene has 3 double bonds, so it has 6 pi electrons. Now we are going to give this number of pi electrons, which is 6 into the Huckel's rule. 6 is equal to 4n plus 2, and by solving this, we get n as 1. So, Huckel's rule is given in benzene, and benzene satisfies Huckel's rule, getting n as a positive integer 1. So, there are compounds having pi electrons like 2, 6, 10, 14, 18, etc. are aromatic because while solving this Huckel's rule, we get n is equal to 0 in case of 2 pi electrons. If n is equal to 1, we get 6 pi electrons. If n is equal to 2, 4 into 2 plus 2 is equal to 10. And then if n is equal to 3, 4 into 3 is 12 plus 2 is equal to 14. So same way, if we solve, we get a number of pi electrons like 2, 6, 10, 14, 18, etc. Such atoms or such molecules are known as aromatic molecules. That is, they satisfy Huckel's rule. So here our benzene satisfy all the four criteria because benzene is planar. Benzene has sp2 hybridization, that is, it is fully conjugated. It's a cyclic molecule and it satisfies Huckel's rule. So we conclude or we can confirm benzene is aromatic in nature. Here is a comparison of aromatic, anti-aromatic and non-aromatic molecules. So we have seen already that aromatic compounds are unusually stable and they are cyclic in nature. They are conjugated having a sp2 hybridization and they have 4n plus 2 pi electrons. They are flat and example given is benzene. Now here anti-aromatic, they are unusually unstable. They may be cyclic, they may be conjugated, but their number of electrons will be 4n. That is, number of pi electrons will be 4n. An example given is cyclobutadiene. Now, non-aromatic molecules, they are like, they are not unusually stable or unusually unstable. The normal stability is given to this non-aromatic molecules. So, they fall under non-aromatic and they fail any one criteria or any one criteria of the four criteria of our aromaticity. Such compounds are known as non-aromatic. Here one example given is cyclooctatetraene. So this is a comparison of aromatic, anti-aromatic and non-aromatic molecules. Based on the topic we discussed, can you guess which one is aromatic and which one is not? Please let me know your answer in the comment section. Thank you. Please like, share, subscribe and keep watching Pharmachemistry Classroom.